All right, what's good, y'all? I'm driving right now. I don't have my my stand with me, so the video might be like wobbly or whatever because this road kind of bumpy. Welcome to DC, you know what I'm saying? So today I just want to explain my new investment strategy, what I'm planning on doing for the next for the foreseeable future. I don't plan on not doing this. And what I'm planning to invest in is Lego sets. I don't know if anybody have looked into Lego sets. I know a lot of people have played with them as children when they're like 5 or 6 years old. Excuse the GPS. I'm trying to figure out where I'm going. But I don't know if anybody has looked at prices of Lego sets, but they've been crazy. You sit there and you see this toy. You see this toy that, you know, 5 and 6 year olds are usually playing with, and then you notice, like, hold up.
Take exit 36. Excuse this. The GPS is the right.
But then you look at the prices of these things, and it's skyrocketed. So what I'm planning on doing is, this is the game plan, right? So Lego makes these sets every 6 months. Every 6 months, they're pumping out a new Lego set because it's a new movie or a new TV show that comes out. So they always want to have a brand new set come out for this thing. And what happens when they do that, they retire the previous set. So let's say I'm looking at like the Mandalorian season one Lego sets. I'm looking at the Marvel Avengers Lego sets. And they ended up getting retired and discontinued from Lego. And what happens is when they get discontinued, these things skyrocket in value because you can no longer buy them in the store. So what I want to do is put together maybe like $5,000-$10,000 worth of sets.
In half a mile, take exit 36 for Old Georgetown Road, Maryland 187 North toward Rockville.
Okay. So what I want to do is over the next 12 months, I want to get a portfolio about $5,000, $10,000 worth of sets that are getting ready to retire. Because I have the retirement list of...
Take exit 36 and keep left at the fork.
But yeah, I'm trying to get a group of the retired sets. I'm looking at the Speed Champions. They're getting ready to retire. I'm looking at some of the Mandalorian season one Lego sets. I'm looking at some of the other Star Wars sets as well.
495 East.
I get it. Thank you, GPS. I'm looking
continue at on I-495 East for 6 miles.
Okay, great. I'm looking at
there's a 10-minute slowdown.
Okay,
in 400
dang
feet.
GPS. Okay, I get it. Okay, DC traffic. Yeah, but I'm also looking at like the Minecraft sets because they do very well post retirement. And if you look at, it's this site called Camel. You can look up what these sets do, like almost like a stock. You can look at the chart how the price appreciates over a certain period of time. Dang, there we go. There goes the light. Over a certain period of time. So what I want to do, I have a couple of sets right here. I bought a few. I'm gonna show y'all when I get in the crib. But what I plan to do is buy about $5,000, $10,000 worth of these sets and then wait until they appreciate in value over the next like 12 months. It's going to be a long process. So probably till like 2022 is when I'm going to be looking to sell these things. And then I'm going to sell it for the appreciated value. So my goal is get 100% returns on this stuff. So the $5,000, $10,000 that I put in, I want to make $10,000, $20,000. Off of this. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to track my journey. I'm going to show y'all exactly what I'm buying. I know some people in the game. I know like Brick Bucks. I've talked to him. He doesn't like to share everything that he's buying because he feels like if he shares it, everybody's going to buy it and, you know, all the resellers are going to be all over it and the price won't appreciate like usual. But I'm going to share exactly what I'm buying. I mean, these sets are like, you can be going to Walmart and look at them. So I'm going to show y'all exactly what I'm buying and the reasons why I'm buying them But the realm I'm going to stick in is the Star Wars, the Minecraft, and the Speed Champions. And I want to do that because they tend to appreciate the most in value. A lot of people like those three themes. So I'm going to stick with those. It's super simple. I'm going to stick with like $20 sets, $50 sets in that range, or just get multiples of them and see what I can do. But I want to know y'all. Want to know what y'all want to see from this Lego investing journey. What do you expect is going to happen over the next 12 months, 24 months with this thing? Are we going to get a nice little appreciation? Is this something that you've ever been interested in? I know a lot of people have never considered investing in Lego sets. It's more like a e-commerce, reselling, retail arbitrage kind of sort of situation. But I think a lot of people will look, so I want to put this video out there just to give y'all some ideas of an investing, being more diverse with your investing portfolio. You don't always have to invest in stocks. I know I like stocks. That's where a lot of my time goes, but, it's important to diversify and also have money in other assets as well. And I think Lego is a good one to get started with. Instead of the real estate, you know, you have your own little side business. You got gold and silver. Now they got the crypto market, but now we want to add some Lego to the portfolio and see how that does over the next month. If it gets really good, which I think it will, I think it's going to actually be pretty good because I'm looking at the numbers over like the years, how Lego performs. It tends to appreciate very well. So, I want to see the next like 12 months, and if it's really good, I'm going to put another 10 grand in there to see what I can do, and maybe we can build this up over the next maybe like 5 years. I'll track my journey. It's going to be a slow journey, but it is what it is. There's nothing wrong with that. We're investing. We're going to maybe big goals, invest to like $100,000 worth of Lego or something like that. I'll probably need a warehouse at that point because right now I'm just storing it in one room. So yeah, and that's another thing about this. It takes up a lot of space. So we're going to have to figure that out. I'm going to have to work all the difficulties of that out. But let me know down in the comments. I want to know from y'all what y'all want to see. Do y'all want to see deeper into what exactly I'm buying? Oh yeah, I do have to show y'all. I'm probably going to show y'all after. I'm going to probably cut it and show y'all. But let me know, is there any other investments that you're all looking at other than the generic investments everybody's on, like stocks and crypto and real estate? Everybody does that, but leave it down in the comments if you have any investments that everybody else isn't looking at, like one of those low-key where the market is really small, really niche, that maybe you could specialize in and get your hands on and really make some good money doing it that nobody really knows about. Let me know down in the comments. I want to know. And yeah, we got a nice little community chat down there, giving everybody some ideas on investments that they can make that aren't the normal ones that we always see. But that's gonna wrap it up for the video. It's not gonna wrap it up. I'm gonna show y'all my what I bought, but then it's gonna wrap it up. But for right now, I'm going to cut it. Because I do not want to crash, and this traffic is getting very heavy at the moment. Welcome to DC traffic. Welcome to DC. But they got the nice Teslas out here. They got the Volkswagens. They got some nice cars, of course, in DC. But yeah, that's going to wrap it up. I'll see y'all in a second.
All right, so here we go. I just wanted to make a quick video. I'm back at the crib right now. I just wanted to make a quick video of what I purchased today from the Lego store. So I got the Lego R2-D2. The reason why I picked this one up is because, one, I got a free gift with purchase when I purchased. Oh crap, it's bent up. That's not good. But I got a free gift with purchase. Not happy about the crease there, but yeah. But I got this for free. And I also got the R2-D2, which is very rare right now. So this thing is hard to find because it's out of stock. So what I did, I put myself on the wait list And as soon as it came out, taking off the wait list, I was able to purchase one. But for right now, the resale value on this thing is $300. I picked it up for $200. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to immediately sell this thing. I already have some offers on eBay for this. So I'm going to sell it. And I'm also going to have this free gift with purchase that I'm going to hold on to see how it appreciates in value over time. I'm not happy about the dent in the box that might mess up the resale value of this thing, but yeah, we'll see how it goes. And also I want to show y'all a couple of things that I've been looking at that I have in my portfolio so far. I'm not going to take out the multiples of them. I'm just going to show you the individual sets that I have. So I have the Mandalorian brickheads. I have a handful of these. The reason why I have this one is because these brickheads usually stay on shelves for about 6 months. So this should be retiring very soon. I wanted to get a handful of those because brickheads tend to do very well in the resale market. I got it for $20, so I'm expecting this thing to be $60 when I sell it. This one as well. This is the Sith Trooper Battle Pack. These usually do very well, the battle packs. I got it for $14.99, I believe, and I'm looking to also sell this one for $60 as well. This one right here, is it Minecraft? I don't know Minecraft. I've never played the game of Minecraft, but I have looked at the chart. So I like this one because Minecraft just tends to do well, and you can literally just close your eyes and pick a Minecraft set, and it tends to do 100% returns very quickly. And last but not least, I have the Speed Champions, the Porsche Turbo. I like this one. I like the car itself. I think it just looks like a very cool car. And on top of that, it's getting ready to retire. So retirement looks cool. Looks like a good return on investment for me. So right now, that's what I'm looking at so far. These are the sets that I'm going to be messing with right now. I haven't added my $5,000 yet. So once I do that, I'm going to show y'all exactly what I purchased. But it's going to be around the same stuff. I'm going to add, I already have my Speed Champions, Star Wars, and Minecraft. That's the main thing I'm going to be buying. So it's just going to be different types of those type of sets. So we'll see how it goes. And I will show y'all in the next video how it goes and exactly. Maybe I'll do like a store vlog of what I'm actually buying. But that's going to wrap it up for today. It's me, your boy, Bust Applesauce. Stay blessed. And I'm going to see y'all next time on Blessed to Invest.
Just to see tomorrow is a blessing. Stay prayed up is the message. Everything about a nigga blessed. Everything about a nigga blessed.